Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back. Happy Wednesday. Today is obviously figure review day, and after multiple weeks, we are finally going to get the opportunity to open up the box set of the Hart Foundation from Mattel Creations as we look at the next release from the Coliseum figure line. So, I do believe that these figures are easy open backing, which will allow us to actually open up a package if we can. So, what am I talking about? The Hart Foundation figures from Mattel Creations. In the past, we've seen the tag team of, or the dual box set of Hogan and Terry Funk. We have seen Jake Roberts with Rick Rude. And finally, we saw in part three, Roddy Piper and George Steele. So, this is going to be the fourth release of the line. And because I always protect these items with care, I'm very meticulous with how I open these packages. And let me get a little knife or something. Sorry, I had to scrape off this stupid tape residue. Alright. I really hope these are easy open figures because I really want to open up the inside and get a full view of each figure. First one we're going to start off with is Bret Hart. And one of the things I really appreciate about the release of these figures, they kind of change out the blue card to the black card. So, you know, looking at the first three releases of this box set, they kind of have that whole LJN feel with it. Especially with the white shirt Hogan. You know, very similar. Terry Funk. Actually, Terry Funk is more reminiscent to his Legends release figure than the actual LJN. But, you know, still, I like that aspect of it, where these figures are very reminiscent to how they looked in LJN. And these are easy to release card backs, which is fantastic. And we know that the Black Card series from LJN has easily the most expensive cards and the most expensive figures in the entire line. The only example of where it might be higher might be if you're looking for the individual cards of the Hart Foundation. You know, those mint cards could fetch around $5,000, right? So, yeah, very expensive figures. So, box set all around. Looks great. Love the backing. Amazing. And I like that they keep these in order of, you know, who was released when. So, that's pretty cool. They kind of got this backwards at top. I would have gone left to right, you know, top to bottom type of deal to make it easier, but that's cool. Alright. Wow, that's pretty nice. Little championship belt. Sticking with the brown belts from LJN for the tag teams. I actually seen these belts on eBay selling, and I think they're asking for like $25 or something just for a championship belt, or maybe even two of them, but I think just one. And don't get me wrong, these are beautiful belts. Rubber, and I guess this is made out of plastic or something. The little plates and stuff on it. I mean, not a $25 belt, though. You gotta throw in a lot more than just a belt. Alright, let's see if I can get this back in here. And it looks like I can. So, one of the first things I'm noticing about Bret is the sunglasses. And I really hope that those are not removable. And they are. I had a feeling the second I saw them on his face, and I'm not happy with that. One thing I do like, at least, they got this, I don't know, you can't make it out in the camera, but it's got like this little white band that's kind of like holding the sunglasses down. I'm not going to display, at least I don't think I'm going to display these out of the box. I mean, I haven't displayed any of the other figures outside of, you know, their original packaging, but Bret Hart is one of my all-time favorite wrestlers. I mean, a true legend. I need one of those old school Bret Hart original, you know, received from him directly at the arena type of deal. One of my favorite things, it was a kid just watching him go outside the ring after he entered and give his sunglasses to some small kid or something. So that was pretty freaking fantastic. Am I in love with the figure? These are not my type of figures, I guess, but I mean, it looks good. It's not crappy. It's definitely not Jack's Pacific or anything like that. And I think I'm already breaking these sunglasses. So, yeah, I don't like that. I don't like that Mattel Superstars does the same thing. They put like these little thin pieces of plastic on like Shawn Michaels and Razor Ramon. And they're removable. Why would you make them removable? He does not need removable sunglasses. So, overall, quality-wise, I mean, I think most parents are probably buying these for their kids. I mean, I'm sure there are some out there who are collecting, and they want that for their collection, but I think figures like these are pretty 50-50. I don't think they're, like, strictly 100% adults. Random Treasures, I would say probably better than 95% of people who buy Random Treasure figures are adult collectors who want them for no other reason than display purposes. But I still think parents are buying these for their kids regardless. Especially, you know, you got fathers out there, even moms who enjoyed wrestling as kids, that want their kids kind of enjoy the same thing that they enjoyed growing up. Yeah, these are definitely getting used. Alright, so Bret Hart was, I would say, a good figure. Good to average. It definitely could have been worse. But the overall design looks nice. Color scheme, you know, fits beautifully. So, no problems with this particular figure. And I'm pretty sure that these boxes here, extra arms and hands and crap, accessories includes inside. Oh, nice. So it's not just a couple different heads and hands, but they actually give you a separate championship belt. And I think that's a WCW belt. Yeah. Okay, yeah. This one, okay, I don't mind. The heads and hands I could care less about, but the addition of a new championship belt. How many times do you watch, like, an adult creator's channel and watch them get all goo-goo gaga over some freaking championship belts? I think that's one thing that every single one of us as kids have the same excuse. We never had freaking belts or all these different accessories as kids because the second we took them out of packages, we immediately lost them. So, I don't know. Now, how did this even go in here? I'll record that later. And then, Jim Neidhart. Yeah, just kind of looking at this with the WCW belt. That actually looks really nice. You know, I might want to display these loose because they look pretty fantastic. Limited edition packaging. So, if this is a limited edition packaging, then who knows? Maybe these will be re-released in blue package in the future. Which means I'm kind of mad that I didn't buy two of them now because I'm going to end up buying the blue package. Why? It's blue. Genius. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to take this one out or anything like that. I just kind of show you up close. The only thing I noticed different here, no, I think Brett had it as well, where the waist, you think about Mattel Retros, where like the waist is like, sits on top of the stomach, right? Or the ab sits on top of the stomach, and their body kind of goes like this. That's kind of the exact feel that this Jim Neidhart gives you. I like the sharpness of his beard, that's pretty awesome. That's how my face is. My face will only grow where the beard goes down like a billy goat or something. Like, I can never get my hair like filled in all the way over here outside of a few patches and then have it like just come straight down, you know, like Santa Claus or something. It's always this. And plus, I'm always, you know, I'm sitting there on the couch kind of thinking to myself. So I'm always stroking the beard and always getting it into like this little triangular shape. So I end up with a billy goat beard. I think I always gravitated towards Jim Neidhart just for that one reason. But no, Jim Neidhart was never really like, I liked him, but I was never like, I never thought he was like a major superstar. I never felt that way about Jim Neidhart. Coco Beware was one of those guys. I'm like, nah. I don't know, man. Repo Man, maybe, would be another one of those guys who I thought had a, who I enjoyed a lot, who I thought had a lot of potential, who I would have liked to see more of, but didn't really have the most successful career type of deal. So, but him as Smash now, different story, right? And again, they got the beautiful pants scheme going. Just how I know of them. Alright, so that's why it wasn't sitting. I had it upwards. Yeah, I'm not going to be... Oh, does this open up? Okay, yeah, not a big deal. It's just regular cardboard in between. And I'm going to assume that the insides look exactly the same as Brett. Heads, hands, another championship belt. Oh, very easy video today, and for some reason, it seems like super dark over there. And, so this video is going to be posted Wednesday, and I think that should be it for this week. Friday, I'm going to obviously start my next tournament, and I don't have any videos planned for Saturday's eBay video. So maybe it'll be another drink and chat type of video where I kind of talk about a little bit of what's going on or some of my experiences with certain buyers or certain sellers on eBay in the past. Yeah, I mean, I think if I don't really have like a main topic for eBay discussion on Saturdays, then that's probably what I'll do. Just kind of like rehash some eBay memories or something. That's it for now, guys. I don't know if Mattel Creations has any more of these figures. If you're interested, definitely check out that website first. Because once these go on eBay, those $60 items are going to cost you $125 to $200. So, that is it for the video. And, yeah, that is it for now. Thanks for watching, everybody. Talk to you soon.